In a remote corner of the Tibetan Plateau, surrounded by towering mountains and deep gorges, China is embarking on its most ambitious hydroelectric project yet. This super dam, planned to be the world's most powerful, could generate enough electricity to power the entire UK for a year. But the location, one of the most inaccessible gorges in Tibet, presents enormous challenges. If successful, this project could shift the geopolitical power balance across South Asia, provided earthquakes don't get in the way. Over the past 70 years, China's consistently pushed the limits of engineering, breaking records in almost every field. Hydropower is no exception. With around 87,000 dams already built, water management is crucial for a nation of 1.4 billion people. China has even redirected major rivers to boost development. We've covered that mind-blowing project in another video, so we won't go into detail on this one. But suffice to say, China's no stranger to massive hydro projects. Even the monumental Three Gorges Dam seems small compared to this new endeavor. There have been some outlandish ideas to bring this project to life. One early suggestion was to use a nuclear explosion to create the dam site. Thankfully, cooler heads prevailed, and that idea got shelved. The potential for hydropower here is enormous, but extracting it is fraught with difficulties. The dam is supposed to be built in a remote, wild part of China that few foreigners ever visit. This mountainous area is prone to natural disasters, and just getting the construction materials there would be a major accomplishment. China's neighbors, India and Bangladesh, share the same river that China wants to build on. They're concerned that a project of this magnitude might seriously affect their access to water, especially with climate change and increasingly unpredictable water flows. Given all these challenges, it's surprising that China's even considering this. So before we dive into how they might actually pull it off, let's try and understand why. Basically, China needs lots of electricity, twice as much as the US and 8 times as much as Russia. Currently, the majority of Chinese electricity is generated by burning coal, which is the dirtiest way to produce power. Coal produces significantly more emissions than alternatives like hydropower. As China aims for net zero emissions and its demand for electricity continues to rise, the goal is to use more renewable energy sources. As a result, China is investing in everything from solar panels and wind turbines to tidal power and hydroelectric dams. Since the 1950s, China's built tens of thousands of dams, including the world's largest and most powerful hydroelectric facility, the Three Gorges Dam. Now, after damming most of their internal rivers, China's turned its attention to major international rivers. China controls most of the water in Asia, largely because of the Tibetan Plateau. With an average altitude of over 4,500 meters, the plateau towers above Asia and covers an area 5 times bigger than France. This incredible altitude means it's filled with glaciers and ice, earning the nickname Earth's Third Pole. As this ice melts, it forms many of the region's largest and most important rivers, such as the Indus, Ganges, Mekong, and Yarlung Tsangpo. The plateau provides so much water that it's known as the Water Tower of Asia. These rivers are not just homes to millions of people. They also support the largest agricultural regions in the countries they flow through, like Pakistan, India, Southeast Asia, and China. The food bowls of these regions are along these rivers. If you think about it, controlling the Tibetan Plateau means controlling the water supply for nearly half the world's population. The specific river China's targeting is the Yarlung Tsangpo, depending on the country it flows through. It's also known as the Xiang or Brahmaputra. Thanks to its extreme white water and numerous waterfalls, many call it the Everest of rivers. To keep things simple, we'll stick with the name Yarlung Tsangpo. The river starts at the Yangtze Glacier and flows over 1,000 kilometers until it reaches the Namcha Barwa Mountain. From there, it turns south, passing through India and Bangladesh before finally emptying into the Indian Ocean. The river's incredible. It's the highest major river in the world, at almost 3,000 kilometers long, one of the longest. As far as we know, no one's ever traveled its entire length, and it's pretty easy to see why. The area where China plans to build the dam is right next to the Indian border and is extremely isolated. It took the British ages to figure out where the river actually flowed through the region. The exact location for the dam is the Yarlung Tsangpo Gorge, a sacred place in Tibetan culture. Believed to contain a hidden entrance to the spirit world, different ethnic groups live within the gorge. Tibetans in the north, the Adi people in the south, and the Bopa in between. The Tibetans believed that a goddess's head rests on the Tibetan Plateau. Her body curves around the river's bends, and her feet end up on the Assamese plains. They consider this entire stretch of river not just a sacred site, but an embodied goddess. However, China is more interested in this place for its unique geography, which makes it ideal for a massive hydropower project. The river descends rapidly as it passes through the gorge, curving around the 7.7 kilometer tall Namcha Barwa Mountain in a huge arc known as the Great Bend. Here, it drops more than 2,000 meters in altitude. For comparison, the Grand Canyon is only 1,857 meters at its deepest point, making the Yarlung Tsangpo Gorge significantly deeper from riverbed to mountain peak. This steep descent makes it one of the steepest river descents on the planet, beginning at over 3,000 meters and dropping to 600 meters within just 100 kilometers. This region is not only a giant natural wonder, but also one of the most remote and inaccessible parts of the world. Scientists are still discovering new species here every year, with camera traps capturing new mammals that no one's ever seen before. It is extraordinary to still be finding new mammals here in 2024. So China has to figure out a way to harness the hydropower without destroying the biodiversity. Despite the mountainous surroundings, China's been developing hydropower on the Yarlung Tsangpo for some time. There are several other hydropower facilities upstream, like the Agu, Jesu, and the Ya'a, and they're nothing compared to the planned 60-gigawatt superdam. Details about the actual plans are vague. Either the government doesn't know exactly how they'll pull it off yet, or they don't want anyone else to know. There are basically two ways they could build it, and both have major challenges. One option is to build a cascade of dams down through the Great Gorge, but this would devastate the biodiverse region. The second option is to dig a tunnel from the highest reach of the river to the bottom, releasing the water through the tunnel to generate power. This second option seems more likely, but it would mean the water would exit right near the Indian border, which is tricky both politically and environmentally. Using the natural flow of the water rather than backing it up to create a reservoir makes more sense in a steep, remote area. This method, called a run-of-the-river system, is common in large projects worldwide, from Brazil to the United States and China. Instead of creating a massive reservoir, water is directed from a high point on the river to a lower point, forced through a power station to spin turbines and generate electricity. The plan for the Yarlung Tsangpo Gorge involves boring a tunnel through the Namcha Barwa Mountain, cutting across the Great Bend. Water would pour down through the tunnel, dropping thousands of meters in altitude and passing through a series of power stations. Reports suggest that there could be as many as 9 separate hydroelectric facilities at the tunnel's bottom. Even the shortest possible tunnel route would be about 40 kilometers long, while another potential route shown on an ABC website runs between the towns of Pei and Meidong, about 50 kilometers long, roughly the same length as the channel tunnel that connects the UK to mainland Europe. A tunnel of this length could carry 2,000 cubic meters of water every second, potentially producing up to 300 billion kilowatt hours of electricity a year. For comparison, the Three Gorges Dam generates about 100 billion kilowatt hours. Despite the massive power generation, the visible construction of this mega dam would look much smaller than the Three Gorges Dam because nature's already created a natural mega project with the gorge's immense drop. However, the challenges of this mega project are immense. Experts say it could be the riskiest, most complicated, and most expensive river project ever undertaken. The region's prone to massive earthquakes, sitting on the Indus-Tsangpo Suture Zone, where India collided with Asia over 50 million years ago. The tectonic plates that collided then are still rubbing against each other, causing significant seismic activity. In 1950, the region experienced one of the most severe earthquakes ever recorded, measuring 8.6 on the Richter scale. The tremors were felt as far away as Kolkata, and water disturbances were registered in England and Norway. The earthquake killed over 700 people in the sparsely populated region and caused landslides that blocked the Yarlung Tsangpo for 8 days. When the dam finally broke, it created a 7-meter high wave that killed over 500 people. Similar earthquakes have been recorded multiple times throughout the 20th century. So it's not a question of if, but rather when another major earthquake hits the region. Landslides are also common. In the last 20 years, the Yarlung Tsangpo has been blocked several times by natural debris. In 2021, a melting glacier fell 4 kilometers into the river just upstream from the Great Bend, creating a backlog visible from satellites. This was far from the only incident of its kind. As work seems to go ahead, China's downstream neighbors are preparing for the potential impacts. Disrupting the Yarlung-Tsangpo's flow could severely affect millions of people in India and Bangladesh. Dams don't just hold back water, they also hold back sediment. Bangladesh is formed by sediment from the Himalayas. Holding back this sediment means less fertile soil for farmers in Assam and Bangladesh, who rely on it during the monsoon season. If China figures out a way to let more sediments through, the impact could be lessened, but the risk remains. The underlying issue here is geopolitics. If one country controls another's water flow, it holds some significant power. Water could become a strategic weapon, a major concern for China and India, given their already tense relationship. In 2020, border tensions led to clashes, resulting in the deaths of 20 Indian soldiers. While China's super dam is unlikely to lead to war, it could strain an already delicate relationship. As the climate heats up, water is becoming a new focal point for strategic competition. China's challenge is to find a way to harness this water without antagonizing India or destroying the environment. If they can manage this, it would be a technological feat comparable to reaching the moon or even Mars. The future of China and India's relationship is just one of the many questions surrounding this mega project. As the world's biggest electricity consumer, China needs to focus on renewable energy, but its neighbors also have the rights to the rivers that have sustained them for centuries. This timeline and cost of the project remain uncertain, but the fact that China is even considering it is remarkable. Given China's track record for building what others can't, they might just pull it off. We're committed to releasing 2 videos a week. Like, share, subscribe, and hit that bell icon for more visionary builds. Thanks so much for watching, and see you next time.